Hi, I'm Benjamin Hunting with AutoByTel, and this is 10 things you need to know about the 2015 Porsche Panamera GTS. Number 10, four-door coupe styling. The 2015 Porsche Panamera GTS, just like every Panamera that came before it, offers a four-door coupe design. What that means when translated from designer language is it has a swept roofline, but it maintains the four doors of a sedan, giving it extra practicality you wouldn't find in a traditional two-door coupe. Some people really like the stretched 911 look that the Panamera offers, but it's a polarizing design at best. There are others who find it simply too bulky, but there's no denying that it's distinctive. There really aren't very many other vehicles on the road that look like the Panamera. Number 9, 2 plus 2 seating. Given that the Porsche Panamera has a four-door coupe design, there's not a ton of room in the back, especially headroom. As a result, Porsche's decided to install a full-length center console and limit the amount of seating in the back to two people. It's actually not really a problem, because if you were seated three abreast back here, you'd probably feel a little claustrophobic. There's another bonus, though, that comes with this four-door coupe design, and that's the fact that the Panamera is actually a hatchback, which means there's a whole bunch of room for hauling all your luggage and other gear. It's much bigger back there than you would find in a sedan about the same size as the Panamera, making the car more practical than you'd think. Number 8, a 4.4-liter, naturally aspirated, 440-horsepower V8 engine. The V8 that you see here before you is the only naturally aspirated 8-cylinder motor you're going to find in the entire Panamera lineup. Below the GTS, you're going to get a V6, and above the GTS, you're going to get a turbocharged version of this engine. 440 horsepower is pretty impressive, as is the 384 pound-feet of torque that also come with the motor. It's made possible by direct fuel injection as well as variable valve timing. It's in fact the same 4.8-liter motor that you would find in the Cayenne, that is the Porsche SUV. Number 7, 7-speed dual-clutch automated gearbox. The Porsche Panamera GTS doesn't come with a traditional automatic transmission. There's no torque converter here. Instead, you've got dual clutches, which allows for much faster gear shifts, in fact, faster than any human being could do with a traditional manual transmission. The official Porsche name for this transmission is called PDK, and it's an acronym that they use so that you can avoid trying to pronounce the incredibly technical description of exactly what is inside this gearbox's innards. You get paddle shifters if you want to shift yourself, which is a lot of fun, and you can also just leave it in drive and tool around. Aside from the lightning-fast shifts, another difference you'll notice between the PDK transmission and a torque converter automatic is the way that off the line, there can sometimes feel like there's a little bit of lag while the clutches engage. Number 6, Sport Chrono. One of the best things about the Panamera GTS is that this trim level bundles together a bunch of sporty features and doesn't really make you pay extra for them. One of those features is Sport Chrono. Now, Sport Chrono consists of an analog lap timer and a digital lap timer. You can see the analog lap timer on the dashboard. It's also a stopwatch. You can use the digital system through the gauge cluster, but it also comes with the Sport Plus button, which is over and above the Sport button that's standard with all versions of the Panamera. Now, Sport Plus will make your shifts even crisper. It will add more steering effort, and it will also engage a number of other performance features associated with the car. Number 5, launch control. Another bonus of having Sport Chrono included free of charge is the fact that you also get a launch control system. Launch control is very, very easy to use with the Panamera GTS. All you have to do is shift it into drive, bury your foot on the brake, and then peg the gas. Revs rise to about 6,000 RPM, you let off the brake, and it goes very, very fast in a straight line, hitting 60 miles per hour in just 4.1 seconds, which is impressive for such an extremely heavy car. Number 4, adaptive air suspension. The Sport Plus fun doesn't end with launch control, because every time you push that button, you drop the car by 50 millimeters. The lower ride height is made possible by the air suspension system that comes standard with every Panamera GTS. That 50 millimeter drop doesn't only give you a lower center of gravity, but letting air out of the air springs gives you a higher spring rate, which translates into better handling. Plus, if you run into a speed bump or an uncooperative driveway, you can push a certain button on the center console that's going to give you 20 millimeters more ride height, so you can actually raise the car when you need to. Number 3, Sport Exhaust System. To be honest, the Sport Exhaust that comes standard with the Porsche Panamera GTS is my favorite feature of the entire car. You push a button on the center console, which is where all of Porsche's buttons live, and extra valving opens up in the exhaust system to go from mildly amusing to absolutely terrifying. Number 2,
especially true if you put the car in Sport or Sport Plus, which automatically activates the Sport exhaust system, and then when you flip the throttle on a downshift, you terrify anyone within a 100-foot radius. It sounds great, it should be standard across the board on all Porsches, but I'm happy that it comes with the GTS. Number two, Active Aero. This wing that you see on the back here of the Porsche Panamera GTS will automatically extend at highway speeds, and if you want to show off around town, just push a button on the console, again with the buttons, and the wing will pop up and then expand, showing your car off to anyone who happens to be looking at its rather generous tail end. Is it necessary? Absolutely not. Is it cool and fun? Definitely. And you know, most Panamera owners aren't going to be taking their car to the track, but if they do, the wing will give them a little bit of extra downforce and stability at higher speeds. Number one, this car is very heavy and very big. The Porsche Panamera, even the GTS model or the Turbo S, is not a four-door 911. It is something else. You can get a stretch version of the car that turns it into a full-size luxury cruiser, but even this thing is a bruiser more than a sports car. In fact, the Panamera feels huge when you're driving it, especially when you're parking it and trying to line those big rear haunches up with the sidewalk or with the yellow and white lines on the road. That being said, it is a markedly different experience from several other similarly priced luxury cars that are out there, which means the Panamera has managed to carve out its own distinct niche and the premium landscape. Thank you for watching 10 Things You Need to Know About the 2015 Porsche Panamera GTS for Autobytel.